Today, we'll talk about examples of application of Newton's laws of motion. We'll start with simple problems and then move on to more complex problems. Let's start with a body resting on flat horizontal surface. It's here. We have to draw all forces acting on that body. It is weight here, W. It is normal force, R, often called reaction force, here. Weight tries to accelerate the body in the direction perpendicular to the surface. Due to that, the body pushes the surface with force of pressure, FP, here. Force of pressure. According to Newton's third law of motion, if there is action, there is reaction, so the ground exerts upward force on the body, normal force, R. The body remains at rest, so according to Newton's first law of motion, weight and force of reaction, so-called normal force, balance each other. Reaction force and weight. These forces balance each other. These vectors are opposite to each other, but their magnitudes are the same. Normal force and pressure force are opposite to each other and have the same magnitudes according to Newton's third law of motion. Pressure force and reaction force. These forces act on different bodies, so they do not balance each other. So, free forces, weight, W, reaction force, R, and pressure force, FP, have the same magnitudes. Magnitude of weight equals mass multiplied by G. You can see it here. Where G is gravitational field strength. It is equal acceleration due to gravity. So, pressure force is also equal to mass times G. If this body is moving in the direction parallel to the surface and there is no friction, velocity will not change, because in the horizontal direction no force acts on the body, and in the vertical direction the same forces act as before, which balance each other. You can see it here. We have the same forces in vertical direction. Weight and normal force balance each other, and there is no force in the horizontal direction. So, velocity does not change, because resultant force is equal to zero. The resultant force is equal to zero, so according to Newton's second law of motion, acceleration is equal to zero. It means that velocity vector does not change. The body moves in a uniform rectilinear motion. Now, if we add external force F, you can see it here, in horizontal direction, then we have all forces that acted before and which balance each other, and external force, which is now resultant force. We have the same forces as before here. These two, weight and normal force, balance each other. And we have external force F in the horizontal direction. And this is also resultant force. Acceleration vector will be equal to external force divided by mass and will be directed the same as external force. In both cases, when the body was initially at rest or it was moving, the body will move in uniformly accelerated rectilinear motion. Magnitude of acceleration is equal magnitude of external force divided by mass. You can see it here. If we add friction force, it doesn't change forces acting in vertical direction. You can see it here, the same forces. And here friction force, external force, velocity, and acceleration. In horizontal direction, resultant force vector will be sum of external force and friction force. So, it will be directed the same as external force because external force has greater magnitude than friction force. Magnitude of resultant force will be equal to difference of magnitude of external force and friction force. Still, it will be uniformly accelerated rectilinear motion. Now, we'll try to calculate acceleration of bodies connected by light inextensible string on a smooth plane. Horizontal force F, we can call it external force also, is applied to the first body, and we assume that there is no friction. In vertical direction, we have weight W2, W1 and reaction forces R1, R2 and pressure forces FP1, FP2 here and here. Pressure forces don't act on these bodies. Weight and normal forces balance each other in both cases, so resultant forces acting on first and second body depend only on horizontal forces. External force tries to accelerate first body. This body is pulling second body by the string with force N2. According to Newton's third law of motion, second body exerts a force on first body, N1. Forces N1 and N2 are opposite to each other. They have the same magnitudes. The speed of the first body increases, so magnitude of external force F is greater than magnitude of N1 force. We write Newton's second law of motion independently for first and second body. Here and here. Acceleration of first and second body is the same, so instead of A1 and A2, we'll write just A. Instead of N1 and N2, we'll write N. At first, we'll find resultant force vectors FR1, FR2. Resultant force 1 is equal to sum of weight W1, normal force R1, external force F, and N1. External force N1, normal force, and weight. Weight W1 and normal force R1 cancel each other, so resultant force vector FR1 equals F plus N1. And magnitude of this vector is equal to magnitude of F minus magnitude of N, because F and N1 are opposite to each other. Resultant force FR2 equals to weight W2 plus normal force R2 plus N2. Weight and normal force cancel each other, so it is equal to N2. And magnitude of resultant force FR2 equals N. It is sum of N2, R2, W2. These two forces balances each other, so they cancel in this equation, and we have only N2. So, to these equations, instead of FR1, we put F minus N here, and instead FR2, we put N. It's done here. Now, we can get rid of these equations N. We can add left sides of these equations and right sides. It's done here and here. And we see that N and N cancel each other. So, we can calculate from this equation magnitude of acceleration. It's done here. We see that we could treat these bodies as one body, and forces N1 and N2 would be just internal forces which don't influence movement of the whole body. Then, resultant force acting on that body would be just external force F. To calculate magnitude of acceleration, it would be enough to divide magnitude of external force F by mass of the whole body M1 plus M2. I think that it is enough for first lesson about applications of Newton's laws of motion. During next lessons, we'll analyze more complex problems. So, it is the end of this lesson. Subscribe if you think that I helped you. We all want to be appreciated by other people, but usually we don't appreciate other people ourselves. The world would be much better if we were not so selfish.